Hi, hello everybody. How are you? Good morning, good afternoon, good evening. Hope this finds you well. So let's talk about the topic for today, which is regarding empathy. So empathy. Remember that we had spoken about empathy. In another video. So we will try to talk about it again, but deeper. So now let's understand the concept of empathy. From where it comes from. So empathy comes from en and pathos. En meaning inside, and pathos meaning pain. Okay, so empathy is not what we usually call today as something that that means to feel what the other one is feeling, but specifically what we are talking about from the very beginning of this word is how you can feel the pain of others. That's the origin of this word, when you feel the pain of others. So basically, empathy means to be in the pain. So remember, don't get confused with sympathy. So remember the difference between these two words. Empathy is to be in the pain of others, to perceive the pain of others, to be in the pain of others. Sympathy, sin means with. So sympathy means to accompany the pain of others, to share, to go with. Okay, so remember, empathy is to be in, and sympathy is to go with, to accompany. So for example, myself, Matias, I am much more sympathetic than empathic, because I don't understand the pain or the suffering of others. I don't really understand it. I can go with, share with, but I will try to make them laugh or whatever, something like this, to feel, to for them to feel them better, because I cannot understand why. So I am not very much empathic. So each one can relate and can know how it is. So it doesn't matter if you are sympathetic or empathic, it's just attributes of different people, so it's okay. We are in the month of Pisces, so we are gonna speak about empathy and not sympathy. And of course, there is a third one that is apathic, okay? So the apathic people are the ones that cannot relate, cannot feel, but neither can accompany. They cannot know how to accompany someone that is feeling bad. So either, even if they are good or bad, the apathic people will just go away and not to be in touch with anyone. And of course, we have the other one that is the antipathic. The anti means against. So antipathic is the ones that they don't want to know anything about anyone. So they just kind of provoke the pain because they're like, I don't care, I don't want, and antipathic, okay? So the apathic is the one that doesn't care because they don't feel anything, and the antipathic would be the ones that are against everything, even if it is good or even if it is bad. So the other opposition is empathic and apathic. So the empathic is the one that can be in the shoes of the other one, that can feel and perceive everything and become feeling that that pain of the other one. And of course, apathic is the one that cannot feel anything and doesn't even care about feeling or not feeling. Remember why Pisces is the empathic sign. Because when you take the zodiac wheel, you will see the 12 zodiac signs around, and Pisces is the last one, is the one that ends the whole turn around the zodiac signs. So this means that a person that have taken all the path and walks around the whole entire circle, they end up in Pisces. That's the last step. So this means that the last one, Pisces, is the one that can understand what each one of the other signs have gone through. The other 11 has gone through many different things. So that's why the Pisces one can perceive, can feel, can be in the pain of the others, because they were there already. So that's why they are able to connect to the feelings of the others. They can hug all of them as one. And the Pisces archetype is the one that loves everyone because they know what they have to go through. So this is why the Pisces aspect of empathy awakens the intuition, because the Pisces perception is the one that allows them to, or this archetype to feel what the others are feeling, even if they are hiding it, because they know what was happening there. They kind of relate with what they were living through. So this is why the Pisces concept is very good listening to the others, giving advices to the others, sharing with others about the deepest part of the mind and the soul. So this is why the Pisces people are also related with the spiritual world, the ones that can perceive, that are sensible to what the other people are feeling. They are the lover ones, the loving ones that unconditionally, and they are related a lot with the psychology and psychiatrist, because they know how to connect, how to feel the other. Bien. So this archetype of Pisces is so sensitive, so open to the etheric realities, living this dream, that usually they connect with the deepest part, the hidden part, which is subtle inside of ourselves, related with the traumas, related with the conflicts, with all the pains that we have within. This is why they can relate to the pain of the people. They can perceive the pain a lot of the of the other ones, the painful memories, and they go to the specific painful aspects of the self, which are much more awakened in the inside. So this is what creates the concept of empathy related to the Pisces concept. The empathy is very close related with suffering in this meaning, talking about pain, which is something that was really used as concepts during the last 2,200 years in our history, because during that time we were in the Pisces era. So the era of Pisces began like 200 years BC, like around 2,200 years ago. And will end in the next 150 years, approximately. So the civilization, the humanity that we had these past 2,000 years has been defined by the suffering. The suffering was like the main key during all this to 2,000 years approximately. So during all this time, what we have been living was this process of suffering constantly, which, remember, the etymology of suffering is sub ferrum in Latin, that means under the iron. So a lot of weight over a person. So in contraposition to the suffering of this time, the religions and the cultures were trying to look for something that we call empathy in order to contrarrest the suffering. And this empathy means to share the weight, to share the heaviness of this iron over our heads, so we can distribute the weight and we can all keep moving, keep going. These 2,000 years that has passed, it was not about to get rid of the suffering, but to distribute the suffering so we can overcome it. So the concept of these 2,000 years was to share, distribute the pain, the suffering. So the way in which you can do this is by offering yourself. So you have to offer yourself to help others to behold, to hold the weight. And the first person that we have the registry that did that offering by its own person to try to hold all the rest of the people and the suffering of others was the teacher, the master, Jesus Christ. So what the master Jesus have done was to take a concept of sacrifice from the past, which was a ceremony done for the divine using animals. And he take that idea and use it with humans, but offering himself. Instead of offering an animal, he offers himself. And that changed the concept for the next 2,000 years, starting a new time, which is a symbolism of the beginning of the Pisces era. So let's go into the etymology of sacrifice so we can understand why then the empathy. So sacrifice comes from two words that in English, when I say it, sounds really bad, which is sack and fuck. So sorry, but that those are the it's the in the etymology, the Indo-European etymology of these two words. So the word sack means to channel. It's what we today call channel. Basically, it means to download the divine into the physical. So a person was channeling the divine, was representing the divine in the matter. So that's suck. Sorry, it's funny in English, but that's suck. So that's the origin of the word sanctum and sacru, which is sacrum. Okay, so sac is the word for channel the divine into a priest, into a matter. Okay, sacrum. So that's the origin of the word sacrum and sanctum. In the other word, we have fac. Fac means to do. So it means to do something. Okay. So when you basically when you do something that is channeling the divine, you might say in the ancient language, you may say sacru facere. Sacru facere. Okay. So it's to do something that is holy, to do something that is channeling the divine into the matter. Sacru facere. So sacrificium, sacrificum is what gives the word sacrifice in English. Okay? Sacrifice. So a sacrifice, as you see, is to do something holy, to download the divine into the matter by doing things, which is a ceremony. So a sacrifice is the action, the act of doing something that is holy, that is divine. Okay, so what happened? That in the old times, during the ceremonies of sacrifice, they used to use blood. So they kill animals to make offerings to the god, to the ground, to the earth. So they used to kill animals. They used to use the blood, the different parts of the animal for these ceremonies. So that's why we relate today the concept of sacrifice with suffering. Okay, we relate the killing of the animal with the sacrifice, which is the ceremony. So as you see, you have in the sacrifice, which is this holy ceremonies, they used to kill animals. So that's why we relate the concept of sacrifice with killing, with suffering. Okay, with this concept of pouring blood. But it doesn't mean that all the sacrifice were using blood. So of course that we cannot judge what was killing these animals, because it's something that we overcome and we are trying to go over it now, but we cannot judge the history. In that time, they were just doing something that for them was holy, because they were giving back to the earth something that the earth gave them. So we eat because of the earth, so we give something back to the earth. The animals were opening a portal to the divine. So that was their tradition. We cannot judge that, okay? We just understand this as a tradition, and now we can overcome this with our awareness. So when Jesus appears in the middle of this process, it changed the whole concept. it stops the idea of the sacrifice as a ceremony where you offer things to the gods and the goddesses from sky or from the earth. They stop doing that. And he stops doing that. And he turns it in a different way. The sacrifice is to offer yourself as a being, an aware being, for the good of everyone, becoming straight that portal as a son of God. And this is what changed the concept. So this passed from the age of Aries to the age of Pisces can be said in the way of, in the time of Aries, they would say, kill them, you know, that, like, kill them all. And in the time of Pisces, he says, don't kill them. I offer myself for the rest. So that's why he starts to say, don't take the blood of the animals, drink my blood. Don't eat those animals, eat my flesh, eat my body. So this concept of drinking the blood of Jesus, of eating the body of Jesus, is the concept that he wanted to leave, that is oneself the only being that must be offered to a God, because you are God. So it's not giving something that is unaware of itself, like an animal, as a gift for others, for the gods. It's better to you give yourself as a proof that you are holy. So this is what makes that the people stop using the sacrifices of animals and they start to make another sacrifice, which is to sharing the wine and the bread, something that the Christians started to do. So now let's go to this idea. 2,000 years ago, this person, Jesus, said, we have to offer ourselves to hold the pain of so much unawareness, so much unconsciousness, that so many other people in the past have been making mistakes. And because of this, we have to help the humanity to overcome all these mistakes, because the next time that we are going to leave the 2,000 years that were after Jesus Christ are going to be one of the most terrible and horrible times. So we need to offer ourselves in order to hold and transcend this time of darkness. You know the concept of the what's the message here? We need to help to this humanity to hold all the suffering that they will feel. So if we hold each other, we are going to be able to transcend these 2,000 years that are coming, that are very heavy, much suffering. So what the idea of the sacrifice was, that he offered himself to sacrifice, to be sacrificated as an animal, so everyone could remember the idea was to sacrifice oneself. To sacrifice oneself in order to transcend oneself. no need to sacrifice something else that is unaware. We need to do this. So then the messengers that he had left spread to the world to bring the messages, the new messages that this master had said. New message, in Greek language, you may say evangelion. So now what happened? With all these people that started to spread, they gave the messages, but the messages were started to be adapted to the people in the different regions. So every region started to interpret the messages according to their own cultures and religions, to their own spirituality. So this is how it was readapting constantly, once and again. So everything started to be changed. The Nordic changed the idea. The Mediterranean people changed the idea. They started to put the images of the solstice and equinoxes, and they started to mix all the religions and cultures, creating a hyper image of Jesus that was never like this. So all this story that we get today about Jesus was not like this. Maybe it's 80 or 90% wrong what we get today, because what he was doing there is nothing related to what we hear today. But only one thing we can say about him, that it's been 2,000 years already and we are here speaking about him and his sacrifice. Practically, the history of Jesus is only the 10% of what we hear today, because most of what we listen today is many other stories that were put in the image of Jesus, but it was not his story. The entire history is all mixed with many different things, which are not the important things, because most of them are just stories that not even him has lived. So the important thing here is the essence of the message that sometimes you cannot even explain. That they went through the history, through many religions, and that you maybe can only feel, not read about it. And one of those changes is the sacrifice of the external changed into the sacrifice of empathy. One point about all this, because sometimes we, even from the negative or the positive, we stop talking about Jesus all the time. And it doesn't matter if he existed or not existed. It doesn't matter even his name. Jesus was the name that people gave to him. Maybe he was called Pepe, I don't know. It doesn't matter. What really important is the message that survived through him. Not if he existed or not. He's a concept beyond a person. Remember that the names are not important, it's a concept. So it's not his name, Jesus. Jesus comes from the word Yeshua. Yeshua means the savior, salvation, okay, Yeshua. So the people call the one that came to save was called Messiah. So Messiah was the one that came to save, and he was the salvation, which is Yeshua, the salvation. Okay, so that's the origin of the name Jesus. Yes. So and then the people said he is the chosen one. The chosen one, in Greek language, you say Christo. So Yeshua Christo is the savior who was chosen. Okay, so basically, what we have of him is not names, is the ways how people used to call him. So I don't know his name, that's why I used to say this person instead of just Jesus. Because Jesus is a concept of people in that time. So now imagine this, that this concept, Jesus Christ, was the fundament of the 2000 years of the Pisces era, in which the empathy was the key of survival of suffering. So the suffering was so much that we needed to hold this suffering by empathy, by helping the others, being servants of the other humans, serve to others, love the others as you would love to be loved. And so distribute the pain and to help the few that are suffering a lot to take the burden of their own crosses. So this concept of empathy, of helping others, is the key during these 2000 years. And we inherit all these concepts through these centuries behind us from this master, from the concept of Jesus Christ, this person that offered himself in order to help us understand the importance of helping others, of being in service to others. And now from that point of view, from the point of view of sacrifice, remember that we have inside the suffering, which was this idea from the animals being killed during the ceremonies of sacrifice. And these animals that were killed for the gods was to kill a goat in order to have more goats as an offering. So that was the whole idea. So throughout the history, and when the Christianity started, we took this idea that we have to suffer in order to make a sacrifice, because we are the new goats, basically. The new sheep, how do you say, lambs. So we are the new ones that must sacrifice in order to show the others by suffering that we are willing to help the others. So this concept of empathy is related with Christianity. So now pay attention to this. All this concept of empathy, which is born from the Christianism, this concept of empathy as the pain, now it doesn't have any meaning, because we are now entering the age of Aquarius. And entering the age of Aquarius means that we are not, like in Pisces, willing to feel everyone and holding everyone. We are entering the age of freedom. Aquarius is freedom. So now the concept of empathy must be taught not by the sacrifice of pain and suffering, but the sacrifice of freedom. The sacrifice is to give everything in order to help the people to set free from the weight of the cross. This is the new time. So all these 2000 years wasn't just about suffering because it was like this. No, the age of Pisces was to teach us about empathy, was the one that taught us how we can understand the suffering of others, how to go into the depth of the darkness of the soul, how can we be in the place of others? How can we relate with others to leave the wars, to leave the conflicts? We needed to understand how it is to feel all that, to be in the place, living all that, in order to now become free. So the message of Jesus was how to be empathic in the time of Pisces. And his teachings are still good for those who need, like us, to learn still how to be empathic with the age of Pisces. Because we are not going to be able to get inside in the freedom of a new time without being empathic with the suffering of the previous era. Remember that the teachings from 2,000 years ago were according to the environment of 2,000 years ago. For an era that we knew, it would have to be very empathic. The question would be now, how are they gonna see us in 2,000 years more? Are we doing right our sacrifice? The vibration for today is pu. The statement for today is, I am the will that creates.